Hey everybody, how's it going? This is Daniel with HT Knowledge to Progress. So today I want to go ahead and talk about Warrior PATHH program. So the Warrior PATHH program is a training program that helps our first responders and veterans how to turn struggle into strength. And what does that mean? We need to understand that what happened to us isn't what defines us. It's not about what happened, but how it made us feel. And being given practices and exercises in order to find a purpose or direction or recalibrate their life compass in some cases, as one of the students said. And as a alumni to the Warrior PATHH program, this is a great program. This is a unique program because the program is facilitated by our first responders and our veterans, those that have gone through the ringer, those have gone through life, the wisdom, experience. It allows us to be able to connect with one another due to our experiences, and having that ability to relate with one another creates relationships and bonds that will last a lifetime. And that's what I like about this program, that it's not like any other program out there. So the Warrior PATHH program is actually the flagship of the Big Red Barn Retreat. The Big Red Barn provides all kinds of other programs, equine therapy, yoga, peer-to-peer coffee groups, music therapy, and other things. But Warrior PATHH program is the flagship program for the Big Red Barn Retreat. Now, about 20 months ago, I actually went to this program. And while I was there, I did actually some talking heads every night. So a few things that I want to talk about before we get into this content is my thoughts pertaining to why I didn't go to the Warrior PATHH previously was because I felt that it wasn't for me. I wasn't struggling as much as others were. I felt like someone else deserved that seat. But 2 days into PATHH, I had a realization, I had epiphany, and I realized that I needed this program. I really did. But again, I wasn't thinking that way. I was thinking about the future of my success, and that's all I could think of. I was in a place where I was trying to get as much knowledge as I could from everywhere because I wanted some knowledge in order to help others. Now, something that I realized that at the time didn't know was that I was struggling. I was thinking to myself, if I'm going to tell others to go to PATHH, I needed to go to PATHH myself. So I used PATHH as a leadership 101 course in order to help others. But boy, did that open up some doors. So when I went through PATHH, my mind changed, I would say, in day two. And that brings me to the content that I'm about to show you right now. So again, while I was there, again, looking at it as a leadership course, I decided to do some talking heads every night. And I recorded myself almost every night. Maybe I missed out on one night, but I captured every single night there. And as you will see, there was a lot of change to the way I was thinking, my mindset while I was there. But day two really, really changed it. I went from looking at it as a leadership course to literally focusing on myself. Since then on, I had a different perspective in life. I've done things differently. I've created routines. I focused on myself, understanding that it's about me, not about everyone else. And if I focus on me, then everything else will fall in place. It's about knowing that I can't be expecting others to do things. The only expectations I need to worry about are those of my own, not everyone else, because I can't control everyone. Because if I were to control somebody, well, then that tells me that somebody else could control me. And do we want to be controlled? No. So again, the only expectations we need to worry about is those that we place on ourselves. And if we do that, we'll fall in place. So with that said, let's go ahead and check out this content. Let's get started.
So this program is here to assist military veterans, first responders, individuals that are going through a PTSD, and I just wanted to go through this course. It's been a while that I've actually wanted to come to this course and go through the course and see what it's all about. What I want to make sure I do first is go through something and then be able to provide that feedback. If you're going to recommend something to someone, you need to go through it first. So there is 7 individuals here, to include myself, that are going to be going through this course together and talking about things. We're going to be getting some training pertaining to getting tools and how to adapt, cope, progress in life with all these emotions and things going on in our lives. Before I came here to the course was that just because you're not having issues or anything like that, or you're not having challenges in your life, doesn't mean that you shouldn't attend. It's a leadership course as well. So me as a combat veteran, I'm doing really good. However, I do have these little small little things that I do question myself sometimes about. Why am I thinking this way? Why am I thinking that way? Why am I feeling this way? And maybe there's something that I might find out that I didn't know about myself that I was going through. So it's something I'm excited to look into and to see what type of tools they have, not just for me, but to share with other veterans out there, especially with having this YouTube channel gives me an opportunity to share things that I'm learning here and be able to share that with you. So yeah, so day one, and I'll see you on day two. Thanks a lot. So today is day two. I am at the Big Red Barn retreat, and I just wanted to go over a few things that I learned today. I really don't want to go into anything in detail. I'm going through my own experience, and for me to share my experience with you, I think it wouldn't be right. I think you definitely wouldn't need to be here in order for you to gain whatever you're going to get out of this program. So I really don't want to go into much detail about day two, but just to let you know that today was really a great day in the direction of the healing process. Long day. It was filled with so many things, so much knowledge that I got out of. So many things that I learned from my brothers that are going through the same things that I'm going through. And I'm so excited to be here. Yeah, I just wanted to share that with you on day two. Everything's going great from yesterday to now. It's just been a real productive 24 hours. And I'm excited to be here, and I'm looking forward to the next steps in this program. If the days continue as they did today, I'm expecting a lot of great things coming out of this program. But again, today is day two. I'm mentally exhausted just because of a lot of sharing we did with each other to build that cohesive bond and trust amongst each other. And it takes effort. And I realized that it takes a step, and the first step is pretty much getting here, getting through those doors and coming here and wanting to get that help from others. And like I said before, this place isn't just for people that are having issues or their lives are being impacted based off of anything that they're going through in life. It's a leadership course as well. Anyone that's been in the military or first responders that have been through any type of traumatic event, I would say if you don't feel like you're being impacted by that darkness within that isn't really impacting your life at this moment, I would then justify coming here as a way to expand your growth. It's a leadership course as well. Yeah, so our struggles are very powerful. It makes us strong. However, it's when we start reminiscing about things, and that's when we start kind of getting into this mindset that we have issues. But when in reality, we need to understand that, look, if it happens, we're going to deal with it based off of what we learned and our experiences. And we need to understand that we're going to react in the right way when it does happen. So day two done, on to day three. It is day three today, and I just wanted to go over some few things that happened today without going into real detail. Today was more of a understanding where we came from and understanding the struggles that I know of in my family. Just because my family went through those struggles doesn't mean that I need to go through those struggles. We shouldn't be saying that, oh, it's part of my family tree. If that's the excuse that we want to make, that my uncle, my mom, my dad, my family, whoever went through that, so obviously I have to go through it. That's just an excuse to justify whatever negative action you've done or you're thinking that you might do or whatever. But today was really reflecting on all these things that occurred in my family, and say that, you know what, it stops with me. And that's what it's all about, you know, self-healing, understanding that things that others do shouldn't influence my actions. And when I do it, that's because I chose to do it. So from that point, you do something negative or you do something positive, and which comes around to something that we spoke about, having situational awareness of your surroundings and yourself as an individual. Understanding that when we amplify negativity to others, we're going to get negative things back. What we need to do is amplify positive things. Everything's about practices, and it's really simple. You know, everything, to be honest, it falls under us as the individuals to put effort, hard work. It takes effort. It takes hard work to do anything. I spoke about it the other day about success. My son going camping, fishing, he'll see success as a straight line up and down. A to B is a success. But for me, getting everything prepped, getting everything done, getting everything set up, getting everything torn down, all that hard work I put in, and then getting back and, hey, we went fishing. I went hunting with my son. That was my success. All that effort I put in. And it's going to be a memory. One day when he grows up, he's going to remember his dad and him going fishing, camping. Today, you know, when I was in my classes, I was taking notes, but I was really making my notes, turning them into quotes. For example, end the trend, you know. I use that quote because it tells me that with all the struggles in my family, negative things that occurred in my family, it's up to me to end the trend, and it stops here. Day 4. So today was a really great day today in this program. I learned a lot of things, got a lot out of today in pertaining to perspective. Telling your story to others is important. You know, it's a way to, you know, it's a way to vent towards others. Now, however, when you tell your story, it's important that not only is it important to tell your story, but it's also important to listen to others as they tell you your story. And that's what it is. We need to put effort into listening to others, sharing our stories with others, and that is going to create a connection. Listening plus sharing equals connection. It creates connection. And that's something that we need to take with us. We need to understand that in order to value ourselves. Understand that we are valuable in this world. We are valuable in our community, social, friends, families. We are valuable in some way. And I believe the way we find that out is by sharing our stories with others. Sometimes it's starting that conversation that's going to create that validation. That in itself validates how valuable you are. Because you're making an impact for yourself and for that individual that you're paying attention to, listening, because that might be the one thing that they need, is someone to listen. What this program does is they communicate these things that you already know in different ways, from different angles. So many methods, so many things, so many practices. There'll come a point somewhere in your life that you hear something that resonates to you. It's like someone shattering that glass, and all of a sudden you're like, you snap because of the one thing that made sense that someone said. Again, day 4, and on to day 5. Good night. It's our final night here at the Big Red Barn. And there's a lot of things that are going in my mind based off what I've learned in the past 5-6 days. It is evening. So it is evening on the 12th. And, you know, so many things are going on in my mind. I am focused on what I need to do at home based off of all the practices I've learned here at the Big Red Barn. And they're practices, not tools, practices. And it is up to me alone, to incorporate those practices. However, I do have my buddies, my tribe. And that's the only time you'll ever hear me say however when it pertains to that, because it is up to me. I have to put the effort and attitude into doing what I need to do. But like I said, I have my tribe as well, and that is another part of my support group. My tribe, which consists of 6 of us, we all have gone through something really special here, and I am so glad and grateful to have shared this experience with them. And you know, so today we learned so much about moving forward with looking at our past and understanding why we're staying present and why we need to move forward. We need to look at challenges as opportunities, you know, opportunities to put these practices that our tribe, me, I've learned here into play. It gives me that opportunity to put that, and I know there's going to be challenges. I mean, not just challenges that I focused here in order to help me out, but I know there's going to be challenges from left and right, from different places. But to me, I'm going to look at it as a positive, as saying, you know what, I got these practices, I'm going to put them into play, and it's going to give me that opportunity to form a negative into a positive. And I'm actually looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to a challenge coming my way in order to implement a practice and look at the outcome. As they've said here, and something that I got out of like almost our last session out of this was that success isn't owned, it's rented, and be ready to pay up. And that is such a great quote. And again, you know, I'm ready to pay up, man. I'm ready to put effort and attitude, and I'm ready to take on the world right now. Again, I have no idea how to emphasize this. If you are thinking about it, or you feel there's no help out there for you, VA is not working for you, please be curious of what this is about, because I'm telling you, it's going to lead you to the right place, which is finding yourself. This is so different than all these other programs out there. And again, I just want to share my thoughts with you. And such a great day. You know, it's a beautiful day today. I'm so happy. I'm really happy, not just for me, but I'm really happy for everyone I love, that I'm going to be able to share my happiness with others and be able to influence them to be happy as well. But like I said, it all starts with me, and I'm going to do it. I can do it, and I will do it, and there's nothing stopping me. Let's get it done.
All of these lines across my face tell you the story of who I am. So many stories of where I've been and how I got to where I am. But these stories don't mean anything when you got no one to tell them to. It's true, I was made for you.